There is a character, creature, who hates joy, doesn't enjoy our singing, does not enjoy our happiness. This creature wants to take from us all that is good. And he listens to our singing and wants to steal our Christmas dinner, wants to steal our Christmas presents, our Christmas trees, all the ornaments, even the little specks for the mice. That Grinch. That Grinch lives, as we see in the story, in quiet loneliness. Thank goodness how blessed he is to have his little doggy. What a dreadful house would that be for the doggy. But nonetheless, he has some companionship. For in the book of Genesis, it says, it is not good for man to be alone. And so, in our neighborhoods, here in Celebration, and further out, Reunion, Davenport, in Champions Gate, and all around, there are people in our neighborhoods who are widowed, yes? Or people might be living single, or those whose families are far away. And so many of you say to your husbands, look, here's a plate. You and the kids go down. Here's a plate for dinner. Here's Christmas cookies. Sit a spell while I get dinner going for us. And you visit with her. Or him. And you might even say, well, why don't you invite them over for dinner? In your lives, how many of you had more than just family at your dinner table for Christmas? Many of you, yes? Raise your hands. If you had more than just yourselves for dinner. Yes, many of you have invited just not your family to dinner. And it is probably, yes. It is not good for us to be alone. We were made, God has made us, to be in relationship. That Grinch didn't understand that. And so, in the story, he takes everything away from the people, doesn't he? And he's so confounded because, did I not take Christmas dinner? Did I not take all the gifts? Did I not take the Christmas trees? And yet, they're still joyful. They're still joyful. We don't have to have a Christmas tree necessarily to have joy at Christmas. We don't have to have gifts. But together we come together as a community, all in relationship, gathering around God's table. Because why? God has such a deep desire to be in relationship with you. God has that desire. Long before we're born, God has a tremendous desire to be close with us. Yes, we're hurting. Some of us. Yes, there are those out of work. Yes, there are those who have very bad health. Yes, there are those who are busy. Yes, those who are working 2 and 3 jobs. Yes, yes, yes. And God says, will you not be in relationship with me, please? And God says, please. And you say, yes. I will come to your church. I will gather around your table. And I will sing. We will sing joyful hymns. Praising you, Lord, for you have been mighty to us. You've been very good to us. God loves to hear from you. God loves that. Well, why does he give me more? Because if he gave you more, he might not hear from you again. Think about it. God loves to hear from you. And so, and it's always, please serve more. Please serve more. God has been so extravagant in his goodness to us, has he not? And so the Grinch makes his way down. What's wonderful in the story is, and this is awesome, as arrogant as the Grinch is, there's a little fissure, like a crack in his heart, yes? We see that beautifully in the cartoon. There's a little crack, a very small fissure. And in a sense, with great prayer and people sacrificing, God's love is able to permeate that cold heart and fill the Grinch with tremendous love. Even when we're upset with God, even when we're struggling with God, or when our friends or family are struggling, we have to pray there's just a small fissure, like a very small opening. It may be, I tell you, it may be where you can hardly see it under a microscope, in which God's mercy is welcome. And as we pray, and as we forgive, as we sacrifice, as we are generous to those in need, as we do that, and we sort of capture God's imagination, because we want so much for others to have the joy we have, and not always expressed exactly the same way. That's okay. God likes joy expressed in so many different ways. That they would allow their hearts to allow God's mercy, expand their heart with love. And thus, really, they would experience the tremendous joy we have. Tremendous joy. One of the greatest attributes of a disciple of Christ is joy. Joy, joy, joy. Not happiness, but joy. And yes, those who have lost loved ones, even in that sadness, there can be joy. And to those who struggle in life, there can be joy. Because no matter the difficulty in our life, we have God with us. We have Emmanuel, God with us. Let us stand and pray.